Hi, I'm Kelly Edwards.
It's Jonathan Golich here, Vice President of the Travel Adventure Show series.
Hey, I'm Pauline Frommer.
And you're watching Movers and Shakers.
Movers and Shakers.
Movers and Shakers.
Unlimited.
What's up, guys? I'm here at the 2020 Travel and Adventure Show, and I'm honored to have special guest Kelly Edwards. How's it going?
It's going great.
Awesome. So tell me, here we are, DC, day one of the show. How's it been so far? I know you just got off stage, you know, talking to a lot of the folks that are here enjoying the show.
It's been amazing. DC means a lot to me. It's where I first met with Travel Channel. I've received a couple of awards here. I've watched many speakers in the audience. So to actually be on the stage where I used to admire people, it's been full circle. So DC is always great. I love being in a place where I can celebrate travel, I can celebrate being African American, and just being in really visible spaces like the Travel and Adventure Show.
Awesome. Now, I was, you know, listening in on, you know, the speech that you had and you talking about your approach and kind of attacking, you know, those things that kind of make you nervous and kind of frighten you a bit. So can you comment further on that and how that has, you know, developed and continued to evolve as you've, you know, continued to travel?
Sure. Well, just if I can put it simply, I'm afraid of heights. I'm afraid of the ocean, but I'm a multi-rated licensed pilot and I'm an open water advanced scuba diver. So I do everything scared. The world is meant to explore, and exploration is not always comfortable, but it doesn't mean that you shouldn't learn about yourself and test your abilities to see what is out there. And because I decide to fear less and not be fearless, the world has opened up to me.
Gotcha. Awesome. And with that, still, has there still come a time, even in that fearlessness, where you still have to pull yourself back and say, okay, this might be taking it a little too far. Maybe I should, like, reassess. I know that I want to, you know, address this fear of mine, but maybe this might be, you know, a bit too much.
Not yet.
Okay.
That
threshold.
I believe in balance, right? So I do things that make me slightly uncomfortable, but that I think that there's a chance for me to get it done. I'll probably never bungee jump. Skydive again. I went skydiving out of the same type of airplane that I fly. Mm-hmm. So two things are going on in my head. I'm looking at the instruments and I'm looking at the pilot to make sure he's doing what I know he should be doing. And then the door opens up and I have to jump out. So, you know, that first 2 seconds of going out was mind blowing to me. I think I prefer to fly the planes instead of jump out of them. But I know for a fact at least I've done it once. I do everything at least once, and if it's not for me to do again, that's okay. But I'm never going to, like, not do something just because it makes me afraid. That's more of a reason for me to at least try.
Okay, and continuing, like, with each of those fears that you commented on, are there some other things that you have yet to do thus far that, you know, address those fears or tackle those fears that you still want to do?
I would love to summit Mount Everest one day. It's a very dangerous thing to do. And, you know, especially with climate change, the ice is melting, the bodies are being revealed. So I can't help to think that, like, would that be a summit that I might not make it down from, but it stays on my mind. So, you know, trying to balance between people being nervous for me, looking at the facts that are there, it's something that I think that maybe one day that I still am going to choose to do.
Mm-hmm. And I was going to say, commenting on that idea, that concept that you're talking about of fear and kind of attacking that fear, I find it kind of ironic considering the landscape that we're in and what we're, you know, what folks are dealing with in terms of thinking about travel and tourism and how that has correlated to, you know, the show today, where we still see such, you know, an impressive amount of folks that want to learn more about travel. So can you comment about that?
Travel is transformative.
Yeah.
So people who have a curiosity about the world are going to find ways to see it.
Regardless of the circumstances.
I'm headed out on a cruise after this, and look what's in the news right now about people being quarantined. I believe that I would rather explore the world and see what comes from that than staying in a comfort zone with four walls of protection, per se. I don't like to think about the what ifs. It's about I did. And that's how I approach life.
Awesome. Well, lastly, and I always like to ask, you know, each of my guests this, you know, I know you have the commitments here. Did you allot yourself, because you were talking about, you know, that balance of quiet time versus, you know, work and doing your travel, doing anything for yourself here in D.C. for, I don't know, maybe for a couple of days before the show started, or did you come like directly the night before?
I got here at 1 o'clock this morning. My life is, it's literally on the fly.
Very compact, yes.
I am always on a plane. When I'm at home, that's the opportunity to do laundry. But I'm usually packing for a new bag. So, you know, for the past 3 years, that's how my life has been. And I try to find some balance in it. But what is home? What is it? I would love to see my home. My home would love to see me for more than a day or two. But that's what I signed up for. I love it. And at some point later on down the line, I'll become more familiar with it. But for right now, yes, getting in, hitting the stage, landing, putting down your stuff, changing, getting the sleep that's needed for the more physical activities I need to do. And that's something I take more consideration for. But yes, I'm always on the go. Just got here. Leaving right after.
All right. There you guys have it. Here we are, 2020 Travel and Adventure Show. Kelly Edwards, Brandon Troy. I'll see you soon.